Hi everyone, welcome. Thanks so much for stopping in. I'm Rena, and in today's Boxes and Deals, I have not just one, but two FabFitFun boxes to show you. One is my annual choice FabFitFun box. I was supposed to have, there will be two that I'm showing you. One is mine, and one is actually my daughter's, kind of by accident. But I will explain more in a moment if you would like to see what is inside both of these Fall FabFitFun 2022 boxes. Please stay tuned. Okay, so what happened is I am subscribed to two annual boxes. One is for me, and I did renew this year. The other one was my daughter's, my 19-year-old daughter. I had subscribed last year for her birthday, and I had asked her this year if she would like to renew, which her renewal was up for the fall box, and if she wanted that again for her birthday. But she had decided that she did not want that again for this year, and so I thought that I had unsubscribed. I remember doing it, but maybe the way my brain has been going, maybe it was all in my head, but I really thought I remembered doing that. I mean, I can visualize going in the app, unsubscribing, double checking, all of that. But during customization, I even went to double check, but the app wasn't working. She has been kind of back and forth and going out of town, and I couldn't get into her, I couldn't sign into her account through the website. Anyway, long story short, when customization was over, I got charged for her renewal. And so we contacted them, and kindly enough, they did refund me for the rest of the year and unsubscribed to the rest of her renewal, but they weren't able to take off the fall box. So they still charged us the $50 for the fall box. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to customize or choose any of her options. So she still got the fall box, and all six of the choices were surprises. So I get to show you two boxes. Box one will be my choices. All six of them I got to choose. So just so you know, annuals do get to choose all six choices, all six categories. Seasonals get to choose the first four categories. Categories five and six will be chosen by FabFitFun. The second box I'll be showing you will be all surprise. This is Kim's box, and all the choices are complete surprises. So here is what I chose and what FabFitFun chose for our second box. Category one, I chose the HEPA air filter. This is by Veo. It is a personal air purifier, so that means it is just for a small space. So we chose that for our bedroom. We thought we would try it out. We do have a lot of pets in our house, and a lot of times I do kind of need a albuterol, an inhaler. So we thought we'd try this out and see if that might help a little bit. That is the box. I'll show you. I did go ahead and take out a lot of items from the packaging so that it saves a little bit of time, but this is what it looks like. If I do get a chance, here is where the cord plugs in. I will go ahead and include, if I have time and get a chance and it doesn't make the video too long, I'll go ahead and include a little snippet of kind of a preview of what I think after trying out some of the products. So maybe I'll try this out in my room, let you know if it's loud or not. I did hear that the light on this, it's like a blue light that does not turn off, so you don't have that option. So if that's going to be bothersome to you, I'd say I don't recommend it, but we'll see how that is and how bright it is. Anyway, so that is that. The air filter is a value of $99. That's what I thought. So I like to do give a breakdown per item, a price breakdown. So how I do that is for my box, since I actually renewed before they did the price change, I am still paying $45 per box until the next renewal. So I do the price breakdown. I added up all the items, all the retail values of all the items that I chose, which added up to $373 retail value for all the items I chose. Now, keep in mind, I didn't choose based on retail value. I know some people do. I chose based on what I would like and what I would use the most, but that's what all my items came out to be. FabFitFun retail value. I know some things seem a bit inflated, but I still feel like even with some of the items being a little inflated on value, I still feel like I got definitely a good value for my money. Anyway, 373, I paid $45 for my box. So then I break that down and get a price per item based on those. So I paid $11.94 for this personal air filter. You can't beat that. You can't find that anywhere, even for a cheap little air purifier. All right, so I think that is an excellent price. Kim got, for her surprise, for category one, she got the Weekender bag by Mally and Lily in black abstract. They had the black abstract or the cream leopard. This is what it looks like up close. Of course, I can barely fit it in the camera. This is one of those kind of, to me, inflated values, but it is an expensive brand. It does feel very nice, but still, to me, a canvas bag at $128 value seems like quite a bit. And especially, I mean, you can see it's barely wider than my shoulders, so that's not that big of a weekender bag to me, in my opinion. So $128 seems like quite a bit, but it does, you definitely can feel the quality. It doesn't feel like your typical canvas, you know, like your what do you call it? Your typical duffel bag that you would find in the sports department by any means. It does feel like much better quality than that. It does feel more luxury. That's what the inside looks like. There is a zipper pocket in there. And looks like we have an additional shoulder strap that you can attach if you'd like. And these are kind of a satiny material. Very nice. So it only has the one inside pocket there that is zipper. And it is kind of a satiny feel inside as well. And then one outside pocket as well. And that's how deep, barely up to my wrist. And that is all the pockets it has. Feels like it's double layered down below. So, yes, $128, but she only paid $18.94 for her bag. Still an amazing value. You can't even get that at, I think, Marshall's for a good tote. So I think even with what I consider an inflated value, I still think she got a really good deal. All right, we did do an add-on. Okay, this was before I realized that we were getting an additional box. If I had known we were getting an additional box, I would not have done add-ons. Trust me, because basically with the add-ons that I did, now I feel like I purchased three boxes. But there was nothing I could do. Anyway, my add-on was the Living Proof full shampoo and conditioner. The add-ons for category one, if you add on anything in that category, if you want something extra, in other words, in addition to your choice, category one, your extra choices are $15. So the Living Proof Conditioner and Shampoo, which I appreciate that they did this time, the set and not the individual ones like they did last season. And it is for fullness. This is a value of $60. So I usually don't buy Living Proof because they are, well, yes, usually overpriced. Sometimes you can find them in Marshalls, but it is hard to find a set. So $15 for the set is an excellent price, so I jumped on that. Moving on to category number two. For my box, I chose, by the way, I do have a previous video out. I don't want to go through all the choices because it would make this video long. I do have a previous video that goes through all the choices, lists all the choices. If you'd like to go watch that, keep in mind that some of the choices will change based on availability, plus for the seasonal choices that will be open beginning the 12th. I'll put the dates up here and in the description below. I can't remember off the top of my head when that ends, but it starts August 12th to open for the seasonal choices. I lost my thought there, but anyway, there's a previous video showing all the choices. Seasonals may get additional choices as well, which if they do, annuals can go into, supposedly, this is what was told, annuals can go into the add-ons and select some of those choices at add-on choice prices. All right, for category number two, we have, or my choice, was the bundle that included, and this was a throwback bundle. I do not remember this, so it might have been a seasonal throwback, but this was a Winter Flower by Craft Crush embroidery set. I'll open that up so you can see it, along with a basket. I'll show you that as well. So it does come with your hoop, and then it comes with your cloth, which is pre-stamped. Now, a lot of people did complain that it was pink, but keep in mind that here are your thread colors. There's not just pink. You can make your flowers any color you want, and if you have other thread colors, get creative. It does come with your needles, your kind of the overall picture, as well as instructions and your guide. So yes, you can just go right over the top of that. You're not going to be able to see that once you put your thread over it. So you can choose any color you want and just get creative. It does not have to match that color. So I'm going to make mine fall colors because I love fall colors. All right, so it came with a embroidery set and an organizational or storage basket. A lot of people had some cute ideas for their baskets. This is how big it is. I did have the dimensions written down, but I don't have it written in front of me, and I don't think it says it on there. This was made in India. It's by, who is it by? There it is right there. Mia Malange. 100% cotton. Handcrafted. It's 9x9. So it can fit on many shelves, even the small like cubicle ones. And it does have two handles right here in black and white. It can fit your arts and crafts even. Plenty of room. And that was a $90 value. Again, personally, I think that is a bit inflated, but I only paid $10.86. Excellent value for both. That's combined, the embroidery and the basket. All right, Kim chose, no, she did not choose. FabFitFun chose for her box the Fit Plan Resilience Band Kit. Came in a bag like this. So it comes with, I believe, three resistance bands, and it came with a 3-month subscription for a fit plan app for 90 days, a workout app. And here are the three bands. So three different sizes or three different strengths. And you can attach whichever one you're using. Here's the handle. Or you can attach multiple at a time if you're super strong. And I'm not sure, I will have to look and see what that one's for. Oh, a door attachment. Cool. Okay. All right, and then I did do an add-on for this category as well. This is the short stories. Now, this one won't be in my video because this was one of those items that they added later that they did not spoil ahead of time. This is a short stories travel blanket. Oh my goodness, it is so soft. And I heard many good things about it. This was a throwback item that many, many people were so happy they got. And it is very soft. And it is thin, but warm and soft and cozy and excellent for traveling. And we do a lot of road trips, so I thought it would be perfect for that. I love the color. It is kind of, they call it ruby wine, and it's a nice long size. It is from my end, because the lights are that direction, I can see through it, but again, it is so soft. I like that it's thin because I live in California, so it's not bulky or heavy. It's nice and thin and soft, and it's perfect for just wrapping around and just give you that extra warmth and coziness. So I like it a lot. It is polyester, viscose, elastane. It is 35 by 78 inches, if you're wondering. There you are. I am very happy I grabbed that. And it is a $68 value, but I added it on for $12. The resistance band kit, by the way, was $67.97 value. She paid $10.06 for that resistance band kit. And that included the 3-month app subscription. Category 3, I chose this hat. It's from ASN. Here's the brand. It is a felt hat, and I thought it would be perfect for fall and winter because here in California, we still get a lot of sun. I have to be very careful about sun exposure, especially on my face, due to a lot of the medications that I take. And yet it still does get pretty chilly here. So I thought this would be perfect for the fall and winter for me here in California. A cute little warm floppy hat. And that's what it looks like. Let me see if it's, yeah, it is a little bit shapeable. The value on this hat is $68. I paid $2.20 for this hat. Wow. How is that? No, okay, I am not reading that correctly. That did not sound right. All right, $8.20 still for a cute little felt hat. Can't beat that. $8.20 for this hat. I like it. And it's a good neutral color that can go with pretty much anything. And it's called the Harper hat. I like it. It is a soft, nice, warm felt. I don't think I would be able to wear it in the summer, at least not here. Maybe in the Pacific Northwest where it's a little cooler, or up in the mountains when we go up to the cabin, I could wear it. Not down here in Central Valley, not at 100 degrees. But all right, then Kim got FFFun chose for her. The Free People who was it collaborated with? I'm trying to find the other name. I don't have it written down. It was this. I already took it out of the outer packaging. So anyway, it was this. It was the packing cubes. So it was a set of two packing cubes, and they are zippers. The zippers are brown. It was something, started with a U, something leather, even though there's no leather on here. So just FYI, so that you're not confused, but it was a leather company that Free People company collaborated with. But that is one of them. It is kind of a bohemian style. And they're just to organize your suitcase when you're packing or your carry-ons. And this is the other one. So I believe, just another FYI, on my previous video, I did put the correct dimensions on the FabFitFun spoilers, unless they fixed it. In the FabFitFun spoilers in the forum, they have the incorrect dimensions. So these are the dimensions. I don't have them in front of me at the moment, but I can write it up here or in the description, but it is in the video, in my previous video as well. They made it sound like they were the same size, but this one is actually quite a bit smaller. But that's what they look like. But yes, it just makes it to where you can pack beauty supplies or clothes or you know, lingerie or socks or whatever. I don't think shoes would fit in there. Maybe flip-flops. Possibly wet clothes. Maybe. It could be waterproof. But it would organize it in your suitcase. Make it easier. All right, those are valued at $40. She paid $5.92. We did not do any add-ons for category 3. Category 4, I chose the Luxie. I have plenty of makeup brushes, but there just wasn't much to choose from, I thought, in category 4, and they didn't do anything new when they did this. You know, they didn't add anything new when they did the customizations. So I chose the Luxie brushes because I don't have any brushes this color. And there just wasn't anything else interesting. I really thought... I also am kind of disappointed because they showed that the carrying case for this would actually be a really pretty one. this is not the carrying case that I thought would come with this. So it's just FYI, this is a clear carrying case with just kind of a green paper that comes inside of it and a green zipper. Yeah, so it's a clear carrying case that, to me, that reduces the retail value on these because it's not the case that that comes with them on the Luxie website. The case that comes with these on the Luxie website is this gorgeous green with some gold, you know, that kind of goes with it. So to me, that gives a false retail value. Anyway, but this is what they look like. But you know, that's kind of not new to FabFitFun. What you get and what, you know, in your box versus what's actually on the brand's website. These brands kind of like to, you know, they don't want to give that good of a deal, I guess. Anyway, supposedly the retail value is $64, but I paid $7.72. So we still got a good value for four nice, pretty green brushes. And Kim got the Wish. Now, I will say I do not care for this brand, but this is the Rose Hip and Lotus Milk Bath, and it is valued at $38. And she paid $5.62. It is sealed, and it is a thick enough seal that I can't get any scent to see if it smells like roses or if it smells more like lotus. So I have no idea. I can't tell you, and I don't really want to open it if I'm going to give it to somebody, you know? All right. This one I did do an add-on. This is by Unite. This is the 7-second leave-in detangler, and we need a really good detangler, especially for Nani's hair. And this is valued at $29.50, but we did the add-on price at $8, which even at Target, you can't buy a really good detangler for, Cantu you can buy for $6, I think, but so I thought I would grab that for $8, and it's 8 ounces, I believe, and I've heard really good things about this brand, so I thought I would give that a try. All right, category number 5, we actually both received this. Okay, this I do have to comment, my little commentary here, when FabFitFun did their spoilers for category for all the categories, they said, and I wish I had a screenshot, but they said that they were going to do highlights for categories 5 and 6, and they said specifically that that meant that for categories 5 and 6, highlights meant they were not spoiling everything that would be in categories 5 and 6, that they would be adding more items to those categories. Now for categories 1 through 4, they said, as usual and has been done in the past, they would add more items as things sold out. But for categories 5 and 6, they were doing highlights because they were going to be adding more categories, not as they sold out, or items, not as they sold out, but that they just didn't want to spoil all the products yet, that they were going to surprise us with more. They didn't add any more items to category 5 at all. They did add more things to category 6, which if I get a chance, I'll show you, or that might be a different video, because I do have another video coming that will be my refills and add-ons and things like that, so I'll show you some of the extra things that they did add to those categories. Anyway, so they didn't add anything new to category 5, which I was very disappointed. So there was nothing in category 5 that I wanted, but I chose the dryer balls because those were the most useful thing to me. We do use them. I already have 2 sets, but we do use them, and they do get stuck in the dryer, in the laundry baskets, that when they're waiting to be folded. So then the next load goes in and we're looking for the dryer balls if people forget to take them out before they, you know, take out their clothes. So, you know, they do get used. But this is by the brand To The Market. They are 100% wool. These ones are made in an organic wool. They are ethically sourced, and they are made in Nepal. I actually haven't heard of this brand before. I have a couple different brands. I think I have Woolsey's and Grove. Oh, just those two, because that's all I have. Now I have actually 4 sets, because I got these, and that's what Kim got as well. So now we have lots of them. We are set. My personal tip is, I do add essential oils to just make it smell nice, and it does work. It does make the clothes smell nice. Someone gave me another tip that if you put, some people are worried about it starting fires in the dryer. Someone said that if you put the essential oils on a cotton, on a cotton ball or a couple cotton balls and put it all in a plastic baggie, plastic Ziploc bag or whatever kind of Ziploc bag, then the wool balls will absorb that scent from the cotton balls, and then you can throw it in the dryer and then it's not directly on the wool balls. So I'm gonna try that. I've never tried it before, but then reduces the any hazards. I mean, I've never had that issue. We've used it all the time, but I'm gonna try it. Then it just reduces that risk. All right, then, so we both got that. For her, since her overall box value was a little bit less than mine, the dryer balls were valued at $20. She paid $2.96 for hers. I mean, hey, you can't get them for that much, that cheap, so that's a good deal. And I paid $2.41 for mine. We did no add-ons for that category. There was nothing, honestly. Now, I am disappointed that they didn't do much in the way of fall, honestly. It would have been nice. They did do a pumpkin eye mask, but I don't use eye masks. So it would have been nice if they had something fall that wasn't skincare. The only two really fall things, at least fall scented things they had, were both skincare. One was a face mask and one was an eye mask, and I don't use those. Oh well, that's my rant. Okay, so category 6. I chose something that I probably wouldn't have chosen if I hadn't seen other people. This was a throwback. A lot of people raved about this and said it was so amazing. So I thought I would give it a try. This is the Stojo cup that everybody raved about. And I love the color. So I thought I would try it. And it's space saving. It is the collapsible cup.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
So, Shauna's in here helping me off to the side, and he makes fun of my cup and mug and drinking ware collection. I love tumblers and mugs and all of that. That's my collection. That's my thing that I collect, and I love them. And so I had to choose one of these, and that's why I was like, it's space saving, and I looked over at him. He did not know what this was until I pulled it out, and I said, it's the collapsible cup. Anyway, I'm kind of trying to figure this out as we go. I'm guessing... All right. Okay, there we go. Okay, I think that's it. Okay, there we go. And then there you go. So let's try that again. And then this gives it the stability. Yes, there we go. And then that's the lid. And it's spill proof. Wait a minute. So what is... Oh, okay. I'm trying to figure out what this is for, but so that is there. And then in order to get this out of the way, you can pop that over here. And pop it in there to get it out of the way. And then there you go. Voila. And put that on. And then just pop that back. And then you can't do that while that's on because of the seal. Collapse it. This reminds me of... What's that little game? And then you just put that back in. Pop it, snap it. Grab it, pull it, I don't know. Anyway, so this comes from... Oh my goodness gracious. This comes with 4 reusable straws. They're cute. All right. We got some. I think the color, the official color of this is plum. We got a plum straw and then some like blush salmon. Pink. I don't know. So anyway, we got some really pretty little straws here. Voila. But this is 12 ounce in size. But some people say they just stick it in their purse, take it with them on the go. This is valued at $32. I paid, I can't read it, $3.86. Oh man, it's hot and I'm getting goofy and we're almost done. And all right, Kim got the bundle, the very one bundle. This is weird that, so they did add, let me see here. Normally in the past, they've had either bundles, like 2 bundles or 3 item bundles. This time they only had one bundle. And it was the Daily Concepts, and it has 2 mitts and a spongel. That was the only bundle at all. They did add some additional skincare. Those were the only items that they added that weren't spoiled ahead of time, were skincare items. So I don't know. I don't know what's going on with FabFitFun this season or last season. I don't know. Anyway, so Kim got the bundle, the bundle. This was Daily Concepts Hammam Mitt. I read what that's about, but I did not read how to pronounce it. Grooming Hammam Mitt and a Body Hammam Mitt. Exfoliate away dead skin without causing irritation. I will say it is way too scratchy for my sensitive skin. But there's a large one and an itty bitty one. This one has the exfoliating side and then a little bit of a softer side, more like a terry cloth. This one is kind of that scratchy on both sides, inside and out. All right. I'm assuming. Oh, okay. I was going to say maybe this one's for the face, but this one says for intimate areas. Okay. So they're both body mitts. And then this one is the spongel in eucalyptus rain, which I would say could be unisex because it's kind of musky. It smells really amazing. It does have that eucalyptus, but also some kind of musk. Mmm, that smells really good. So, of course, I'm sure everyone is familiar with spongel, but it's the body wash flower that already has the soap in it. Mm. And multi-use cleanse, exfoliate, massage, nourish. Usually they say how many washes it has. This one does not. All right, so this bundle is valued at $44, and she paid $6.51. All right, and then I did go ahead and add on just because, I mean, I'm so stocked up on skincare, I don't really need it, but I couldn't pass this up. I do need something for the texture for my skin and some brightening. This one is Kate Somerville Vitamin B3 and Vitamin C Serum. It is a value of $98 and I added it for $10. So I thought, and it's for brightening and evening. So I thought I would give it a try. I do like some of her products. So I thought I would try that out. And that is what we added. I thought I would go ahead and show you some of the past items that are in the choices. If they do come out in the seasonal and add some more items, I can maybe throw those in the video and speak over. But in category one, really quick, they did also have the Phantom Chef fry pan. I absolutely love this pan. Even though it's little, we use it for omelets or eggs or like grilled cheese sandwiches, even tortillas, if the small tortillas, all kinds of things. But I love it. It is absolutely nonstick, so easy to wash. It's probably our most nonstick pan we have, but I will say that it does chip on the edges, and I've heard other people say that, so just be careful about, you know, whatever you might bang on the edges or whatever. This is very soft. It is not wood. I see a lot of people ask about that. I don't know what you would call that material. It kind of feels like a silicone. It's not. I don't know what it is. It's a soft material, but I love it. This can easily be cleaned with, what do you call that? That pink stuff. Anyway, this is the Phantom Chef fry pan. Absolutely worth it. The category two, Glow Recipe Juice Moisturizer. I like it, but I will say that if you have dry skin, you would need an extra moisturizer on top. I would use it more as a serum. It smells amazing if you like watermelon. Category number three, the Michael Kors Beanie. Kim got this. She loves it, but you can only hand wash it, so keep that in mind. But she does like it. It's not super soft or super stretchy, anything like that, like you would think an expensive Michael Kors Beanie would be. It's not super thick or anything. Like, it just feels like a cheap beanie, honestly. It does not feel like, I don't even remember how much this is valued to be, but it's not what you would expect for Michael Kors, let me tell you that. She likes it though. But there's that. And then the Buffalo Check baseball cap. I really like it. It's really soft. It is very fall, especially like October and November. It being gray and cream, it can go with a lot, but at the same time being checkered, I mean, it's up to you what you would put with it. I don't find a lot for it to go with unless I'm wearing a lot of black. So, I don't know. I like it though. I have gotten a lot of use out of it, but I feel like I get a lot more use out of my plain colored ones. But I think it's cute. It is soft and it fits well. And I do like the back and where it goes in. And then I would show you the Cloud Nola block clock, but I can't find mine. And the reason I can't find mine is because I don't use it anymore. And the reason I don't use it anymore is because I can't get it to work. I've had trouble with it. It worked for a little while, but then I kept having to replace the batteries. I couldn't get it to charge. It's had issues, and I don't know. Maybe I just got a glitchy one, but I've seen other people complain about theirs. So personally, I don't know if I would recommend it. Other people have better opinions of it, but that's mine. All right, what do you think? What did you get in your box if you got FabFitFun and you're an annual? If you're a seasonal, what are you choosing for yours? If you're not a FabFitFun member, are you deciding? I don't know about this season, but I will say I am happy with what I got. This isn't my favorite season. But let's see, what's my favorite item? I don't know. I'll have to try this out and see what I think. I'm happy to get it and try it out. I can't say it's my favorite quite yet because I haven't tried it, but I'm excited to try it. Oh yes, I am excited about the hat. Now, believe it or not, this is probably the thing I was the most excited about for the box, which is pretty sad considering it's a hat. It was the most fall thing out of the box. I don't know. What do you think? What are your thoughts about the fall season? I'm excited about my coat. Yeah. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Be sure to watch out for the next video coming out because I do have a mystery bundle for the refill, the home bundle, the surprise candle. I think that's it. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.